For many years now, I've had a fascination with the cephalopods, so the octopus, cuttlefish and squid. They have an eye which is famous for having what's called convergent evolution. So it looks initially very much like the human's eye.
My name is Wensung Chung. I'm postdoc in Marshall's lab. Yeah, I'm working on cephalopod vision and taxonomy, and my current project is working on the neural anatomy.
So this is a particular behavioural experiment in which we're testing animals to see if they can see polarised light. And the way in which we do that is take an ordinary computer monitor, like this one, put a razor blade and scrape the front off. Now what that actually does is it removes the front bit of Polaroid, and now what that does, if you're an animal with polarising vision, you can see something. So the little video clip here actually shows a cuttlefish reacting to the presentation of a stimulus, which is represented by this. But it only sees it because it has polarising vision.
You can see here, in front of the arm, you can see the flashing, white and the dark. That's a very strong polarised reflection. We are going to test if this polarised reflection signal is important for their sexual selection or for the communication.
And again, we take very much a comparative approach. You know, comparing, for instance, an octopus living on the reef, how is its visual system different to the cuttlefish which hovers overhead? And then the squid which whizzed past in the distance. How are their eyes different from their two cousins?
A couple of years ago, I went to Japan to do the giant squid expedition, and we filmed the first ever live giant squid using the submersible. So when we arrived at Ogasawara, Medusa spent 30 hours underwater. And unfortunately, the whole 30 hours footage, we can't see any animal, nothing there, so we really worry about it. Whole expedition, we accumulate 242 hours footage, and then the most exciting footage was at the fifth deployment. After 24 hours footage, nothing on the screen is boring and it made me sleepy. Then suddenly I saw something big. So when this giant squid come from the left-hand side of the camera and open their arm crown, expose their buccal mass and the buccal membrane, then I saw, oh my god, it's a real giant squid. Yeah, and I call Dr. Cupdera and Dr. Steve O'Shea, these two experts of deep sea squid. We can count the buccal membrane and the connection type, then we 100% sure this giant squid.
Are you the first person to see live footage of a giant squid in its natural habitat?
Yes, I'm super lucky. Yeah. It's very difficult to describe the feeling. Yeah, even now I still feel very excited.